Damn, that's gonna be good. Grammy Awards has several number one hits and paved the road for a generation of alternative rock bands. Here to perform from their 11th CD Up, please welcome R.E.M.
Sucked up the overage. Directives are posted, no callbacks, complaints. Everywhere is calm. Hong Kong is present, Taipei awakes all. Talk of circadian rhythm. I see today with the newsprint. Gray, my night is colored.
CD is up. Michael, Peter, and Mike, how are you guys?
Great.
Pretty
great,
good. It's a little early in the day for me to be singing.
Yeah. Really? What time do you usually get up? Are you a morning
11.
Morning guy?
Yeah.
11? How about you, Peter?
I have kids, but 11.
11. Yeah.
We have them on a late schedule, so.
You have twin boys?
Girls.
Twin girls?
Yeah.
How old?
Four and a half.
Four and a half. And they come on tour with you?
Mm-hmm. They do everything. They come and bother these guys late at night and early in the morning.
Yeah, we love them, though. They're
yeah, it must be really wonderful to have kids while you tour,
yes.
You know, to keep sort of a realness there.
We've been around, you know, together for so long that we're like family anyway, so it's my real family, my adopted family. These guys are kind of the same thing.
Thank you.
It's pretty great.
Hey, Mike, how about you? What time you get up?
10:30, 11, unless I go out the night before, in which case it's
that's
late.
Not, you guys are laughing, like that's, but I don't go to bed until whatever, 5 o'clock in the morning, so.
Yeah, right. It's a whole different world for most people,
yeah.
You know? When I did stand-up, it was the same thing. I didn't get up till noon.
Well, and now you just had to completely turn your schedule around, probably.
Because of the show, right, because yeah. I have two children.
Yeah.
Who do not sleep until 11. I hope you can tell me how you accomplished that.
Keep them up till midnight.
Yeah. Keep them up till midnight, yeah. Now, the drummer recently left the band. That must have been very difficult for everyone.
It was about a year ago we were starting this record, and he decided he wanted to retire. He didn't want to be 40 years old and in a rock band.
Right.
And so now he makes hay. Like, makes hay?
He's a farmer.
All the sun shines.
Yeah. He's a farmer.
He probably makes hay too, but...
Guarantee he doesn't get up at 11 if he's a farmer.
No, he gets up at 6:30. That's why one reason he hated this life, because he had to get up so... Because he likes to get up early. And we get up at 6:30 on the road and there's nobody to talk to because we're all sleeping.
Right. Now, that must have been hard when he left. How did you find a replacement? Was it a bit difficult thing to do?
Well, you know, we're just kind of going on as the three of us, and we're working with Joey Warnaker, who we've known. His dad signed us to Warner Brothers 10, 12 years ago. We've known him since he was a teenager. But, you know, we're just at, when he first left, we just kind of decided we'll just go on as the three piece and figure out how to do it later on.
Right.
So we haven't really figured it out yet.
We made the record using a lot of, a lot of friends who came in and played different instruments, and most of the songs were written using drum machines and no guitar, which is unusual for us. But the last record that we made was really like drums, bass, guitar, vocal. I think these guys, when they went to write the music to Up, they felt like we'd done that as well as we could and wanted to try something different. So it's a very experimental record for R.E.M.
And it's a great record. I love it.
Thank you.
It's really wonderful.
I'm really proud of it.
I hear you had a career high yesterday.
Indeed.
You accomplished something entertainers wish for and dream of for years.
Yesterday on Thursday, right?
Yeah, yesterday.
Is it Friday or?
Today's Friday. So yesterday was Thursday, exactly right.
Right.
So actually it wasn't yesterday, it was really Monday that you did this.
That's
which
right.
Isn't yesterday unless you're here today, but you're not because it's Friday where you are.
We'll
tell everyone what you did.
We did Sesame Street.
Did Sesame Street.
Sesame Street! Was it fun?
It was fun.
I was in the most foul mood yesterday morning. Partly because they got me up really early, but mostly it was just a bad day. But you know, you can't be anything but cheerful around the Muppets.
Right.
I got on the set, and this is great. I was supposed to go to a movie last night to see a friend, and I couldn't go. But I got to call and say, I've been on Sesame Street. I couldn't make it. I'm sorry.
I'm exhausted.
I'm exhausted. The Muppets are like they're up and down and up and down. they're like some really extreme version of bipolar mood disorder. All of them. It's kind of great though.
Did you sing a song? Did you?
Oh boy.
What did you sing?
Furry happy monsters.
Fun, isn't it?
It was great.
Did your daughters get to go there with you?
Yeah, and they got to talk to Elmo. I mean, they knew it was a puppet, and they looked him right in the face and talked to him for about 10 minutes, very seriously. So did we, though.
Yeah.
So.
They kissed Elmo, too.
Yeah.
You have to get a kiss from Zoe or Zelda. Not one of them has ever kissed me.
Really?
You should get furry.
Oh.
Well, I don't think they like this.
You think that's what it is? Look, I have an Elmo for you. You want? Here's a Zoe, too. Oh, no, this is Snuffy. Look,
Snuffy's
here.
If I put it near my mouth.
There you go. In fact, take these home. When you're on the road.
The next time I see Zoe and Zelda, I'll just duct tape this to my chin.
You'll get a big plant one right there. It's lovely to see you guys, and it's nice to have you on the show. I really appreciate you being here.
It's a partnership between West Channel 2 and the Orlando Sentinel. Hi, I'm Mark Middleton, News Channel 2 sports director and host of the first and only TV show on local high school sports. For in-depth coverage of girls and boys high school sports, watch the Orlando Sentinel High School Sports Show Saturday at 11:30 on West Channel 2.
The average kid doesn't get straight A's.
The average kid could live on french fries.
I could live on pizza and ice cream.
Gummy bears.
The average kid trusts their friends more than anybody.
The average kid is totally bored.
Totally bored.
The average kid has a lot more on their mind than you think.
The average kid is pretty strange.
The average kid has been offered pot.
The average kid thinks everybody else smokes it,
but the average kid doesn't.
The average kid is anything but.
Young beefy boy, your training will be complete if you can grab this can from my hand.
You're too slow. Down below.
Beefy.
Nominate outstanding youth for the Jefferson Award, deadline February 22nd.
It's time to forget about the Super Bowl, to ignore the NBA. If they don't play it at a Central Florida high school, we don't cover it, period. If they do, we're all over it. No other show in town.